What is up, YouTube? I'm Devon DaVinci, leader of the Renaissance crew, and you're watching DaVinci Watch or DaVinci Reacts. Again, pay attention to the title because it's important. Today we're going to be getting into season 4, episode 4 of Peep Show, called Handyman, and don't really know what to expect. I did have a comment from somebody that said something about, like, I should stop calling it season 4 and start calling it series 4. They seem very high-strung about it, so let me go ahead and explain why I say season, even though you call it series. I know it's an English term, well, not really English term, but you guys use it for English shows to mean what we would call in America seasons. The reason why I say seasons instead of series is because saying series by itself is extremely confusing, because I know in America, series means the entire show. So all the seasons combined, that is the series. I don't know if it's the same for you guys or not. I would imagine you might have a different term for it, but to separate myself from referring to the overall show and just the specific collection of videos or collection of episodes, I refer to season for the collection of episodes and series for the show as a whole. So that's the reason why I do it. It's easier for me, and it's less confusing for people that might be watching this maybe outside the UK. Maybe the UK might be confusing too. Like I said, I don't know if you guys use the term series to refer to the entire show, but that's what I've always done. But anyway, let's just jump into this, see what it has to offer. For those of you that don't know how to follow along with DaVinci Watch videos, watch the tutorial at the beginning of the video. It will explain how to follow along with me. And, well, come back and get ready for the countdown. For those of you that do know how to do DaVinci Watch videos, I'm about to do the 3-second countdown. When I say go, everybody hit the play button at the same time, and we should be synced up. Obviously, you need a Netflix membership in order to watch this along with me. If you want to use the Channel 4 version, you can do that as well, but just know the Netflix version has an intro that is extra, so you have to wait for the first intro to go away, and then when the theme song kicks in, that's where you would sync the video up for the Channel 4 version. I would use Channel 4 version, but for some reason I can't. Every time I try to do it, it gives me issues. But it didn't used to do that, but now it gives me a lot of issues. With that being said, let's go ahead and sync up. 3, 2, 1. Click play on go, obviously.
What a dud evening. Low quality takeaway, low quality detective drama, low quality sexual intercourse.
So, do you fancy coming along to my school reunion?
Now you're judging the school reunion. Intercourse? Damn.
That doesn't sound very you.
Yeah, but I thought it might be nice to go and you know, show them all that I've got a job and a flat and a fiancé now, and I'm not, in fact, a gender bender, a mentaloid, or a public leaning post after all.
Right. Okay, the thing is, I think I mentioned I'll be heading off late Saturday night.
What thing?
Frankfurt, Marketing Development Group, me and Alan and Lisa and Jeff.
Jeff's going to you're going to Frankfurt with your ex?
Not with him. It's work, Mark. Did I not mention it?
No, you did not mention it.
Oh, well, I thought you knew. Well, you do now, sir.
Yes, I know now.
That's a bad sign.
Before.
Well, you do now, sir.
Right.
Okay, definitely have a legitimate grievance here, I reckon.
Use that as an excuse to get
Let's
out.
Let's milk it.
Mark, Jeff and I aren't going to fall into each other's arms in a pile of sauerkraut. I am getting married to you, okay?
That's a weird-ass term.
Maybe I should just go on my own. Sally Slater might be there.
Maybe it's in
Sally,
one
of the few
English
girls
thing?
In my year to notice me and yet still not mock. It'd be good to see her again, and I'm sure Sophie won't mind. In fact, she's definitely not going to mind because I'm not going to tell her.
Oh, great night at the pub this is. Laura's caught in Superhands' tractor beam. Kerry's being all lovely to Mike about his mum's thyroid thing. I've got no way out. Stuck with a newbie, Mr. Fucking Shirt. Got to say something. So, how do you know everyone?
Oh, I'm a friend of Bob's, mate, Kev. And he said it was a friendly crowd and come down, so I thought, yeah.
Cool. Jesus, come on. Throw me a bone. So, have you got any plans for the weekend?
I'm doing a gig, actually.
All right.
Oh, playing with my old outfit as the Orgazoid.
You're the Orgazoid? Oh, my God. I thought you were just a man in a shirt sitting on a chair. Your first two CDs, I know every track.
Borneo Function.
Right. Nice.
Hans, it's not just a man. This is the Orgazoid.
Yeah, I know.
Why didn't you say? Can I get you a drink?
Oh, I'm full of Diet Coke here, man. Yeah, I haven't had a proper drink for 6 years. None of the party powder either.
Oh, right. I mean, you've been as high as it's possible to go.
Well, yeah. Yeah, I suppose I have.
And you've been as low as it's possible to get.
Yeah. Yeah, I have.
And what's it like when you're up that high?
It's incredible.
And what's it like when you're down that low?
Ah, it's terrible.
It's horrible.
And what's it like when you're in the middle?
It's, you know, it's fine.
Wow.
It's like when you're in the middle.
So, listen, weird question. I'm not sure if you're looking for work or what, but I'm looking for a kind of, like, handyman. Now, my place is going to shit since I split up with my ex.
Well, that sounds amazing. Orgazoid's handyman. This is a dream come true. Handyman to chauffeur to keyboard player. It's a very well-established career path. Oh, man, my job is the nuts. I had a great first day.
By your job, you mean being a handyman for a man called the Orgazoid?
He's not a man, he's a band. He's one of the most brilliant techno pioneers of all time, and he's paying me 500 quid a week in advance in cash.
What? Come on, Jeremy, nobody gets paid £500 a week to do nothing.
It's not nothing. Making smoothies from a smoothie maker is not nothing. You should try cleaning one of those mothers.
No, there's got to be a catch. You're going to be his drugs mule.
That's why McDonald's always
invite a German round from the internet to eat you. I mean, where did you even meet him? The snooker club that used to be a public toilet? Seriously, I'm concerned about this arrangement.
Why does everything good have to be some horrible arrangement? Me and Russell are just two guys having a nice time. That's what life is supposed to be like, in case you've forgotten.
All right, whatever. Look, I'm going out, so...
Going out? What? He's not going out. He can't. He doesn't know how. Where? Who with?
Just to a nightclub.
A nightclub?
Yes. Well, as you're always saying, the Beastie Boys fought and possibly died for my right to party, so...
Mark, come on. What the hell's going on?
All right. Look, I've been invited to the Polefield school reunion at a school disco club, and...
But they all hated you at Polefield.
Well, the vast majority, but there were some crumbs of comfort. The chess players, the musicians, the poor and the posh-voiced. We formed a substrata, a secret society, below the radar of the norms.
The norms?
The normallos, the Norman forces, our oppressors.
Right. Well, this I have got to see. I could invite Nancy. Yeah, brilliant excuse to see her.
Haven't you got work in the morning?
Oh, yeah. That's really going to break his balls if I roll in an hour late. Mark, this is Russell Orgazoid. He's a creative. I'm a creative. We don't make steam engines out of pig iron in this country anymore, yeah? We hang out, we fuck around on the PlayStation, we have some Ben and Jerry's. That's how everyone makes their money now, yeah?
Here they all are, my tormentors.
Hope Nancy gets here soon. This is gonna be perfect. She won't know anyone except me.
That's Faisal Butt. He used to call me a flod. I think it was a mixture between a flid and a spod.
The hell's it?
That's
what was that?
Foz. He used to sit behind me in French and put bacon on my shoulders.
The fuck?
That's Kerry Carpenter. One of the more sophisticated bullies. Pretended I was Thatcher and he was Heseltine and I needed ousting. I need a drink.
Oh my God. There she is. Lovely Sally Slater. I should speak to her. But what the hell can I say? Anything that doesn't mention I masturbate over her memory is probably good. I mean, I think that's a compliment, but women just don't seem to want to hear it. No, just spend the evening looking longingly at her from a distance. Like the good old days.
She doesn't like she's having fun.
Mark! Is it Mark Corrigan? Yeah, I forget. Are you Sally? Good to see you. I have a job and a flat of my own now, so it's great to see you. God, you look great.
Thanks. So, listen, can I get you a drink?
Oh, okay.
She wants to buy you a drink.
Great. Maybe everything will be different.
That might
now.
Be a red flag.
Maybe all the parameters have shifted. Most of my rivals from school have probably perished in Blair's oil wars.
Something's
hey,
going
Nancy.
On.
Hey, Jess. Great idea. This is so much fun.
We're gonna meet these great guys.
She made some friends pretty fucking quick.
Damn straight.
So now I'm finally doing an English degree, and I do a bit of cleaning to pay the bills. I listen to the set text on my iPod when I'm hoovering.
Right, that's cool. I hoover sometimes because I bought my flat and that, and from my job as an executive, I had plenty of cash left over to buy a hoover.
Are you boasting, Corrigan?
No.
Yes.
I mean, maybe a bit. Do you remember on that history field trip where you borrowed my Hitchhiker's Guide and we both read it out in funny voices?
Yeah.
I was thinking that was probably one of the best days of my life.
What, really?
Should I feel guilty? No, Sophie's probably doing it with Jeff to the brutal rhythm of the Umpar band. Why shouldn't I have some mild flirtation? A snog, even. Or more?
Hello, sexy.
Oh, great. Bacon shoulders.
Bacon Mark, you shoulders. Remember Foz?
All right, Corrigan.
Hi, Foz. Please don't hit me for any reason, Foz.
Foz and I are married now.
Oh, Foz, oh, right. Please don't hit me.
Great. Obviously, of course. Why didn't I just buy an anvil and smash my face onto it? It'd certainly be less hassle.
So, have you got kids?
Not yet.
Why?
Oh, no reason. I mean, I love kids. Not in a bad way, in a nice way.
In order to restore your manhood,
I mean,
Mark, you
I'm
know what
you have to do. I'm not on the child protection register.
You have to sleep with his woman.
Which proves I'm not a pedo. This is going horribly. Need a joke. Either that or I'm incredibly hard to detect, pedo.
Oh my god.
Just move on from the pedo area entirely. Jez, this is Foz and Sally. Jeremy.
All right, mate. So, your mates were wanker fun.
I'm sorry?
Mark Wanker fun, you remember? At school, and you got taught the wrong way to rub one out and you tried it for 2 hours.
Shit, this is just like school. Have to side with the powerful to survive.
Damn it, Jeremy. That's fucked up.
Oh, my love.
That's fucking fucked up.
Just like school. I have to sit and watch while the beautiful people dance at me.
Yeah, we're going to throw you under the bus.
No, she wants me to call her. It's worked. All my references to how much above the national average income I earn have actually worked.
Oh yeah, making smoothies at the Orgazoid's house. This is the kind of job I deserve. I've paid my dues, all those years signing on every bloody week.
Ah, nice. Thanks, man. Yeah, take 5 if you want, swim a few links.
Oh, cheers, Russell. Yeah, maybe I will. Nothing dodgy about this. Just going for a swim in my trunks. I can't swim in a 3-piece suit. So screw you, cynics.
Ah, now listen, before I forget, I thought you might like this. I did a few different versions of Borneo Function and never got released. I thought you might get a kick out of them.
Oh my god. Wow, Subans is gonna shit a brick when I show him this. Finally, something to beat that car battery he nicked off the Prodigy.
Okay, well, great chatting to you, Sally.
Hi, honey, I'm home.
And good luck with Midnight's Children. Remember, no one's ever actually finished it. Bye. Great call. Friendly but flirty. Didn't overstep the mark. I could show Sophie the transcript. Maybe I should start taping my phone calls. No, Mark. That's how they got Nixon.
I might
What's
be wrong,
that?
So.
Oh, just
I'm not
going to
say anything until.
He bought you a jumper.
I get some evidence.
What else has he bought you?
Nothing. Jesus. Squash racket?
Jeremy, what's going on? Squash rackets are not a normal form of remuneration.
He doesn't have anyone to play with. And 2 people can't share one bloody racket. Case closed, Columbo.
So, listen, I've organised a trip to the Safari Park on Saturday with Sally and Foz.
The Safari Park? With that dickhead Foz? Have you gone mental?
It's an ironical day out.
Oh, I get it. You're just another dirty dog like everyone else.
I am not a dirty dog.
Yeah.
But I do need you to come as my sheath.
Your sheath?
Yes, as long as you're there, it's just 4 people having an apparently nice time at an outdated venue.
Fucking hell. What's going on? Are you trying to get your end away while Sophie's not here?
Sophie has not called me once yet. So there is actually a perfectly valid excuse for what I'm almost certainly not going to try to do, okay?
Okay, if Sally was sitting here now and she said, Mark, let's do it, what would you say?
If she promised she wasn't a Glenn Close type and happened to have a recent clean aid certificate.
Yes.
That's a hypothetical question. I don't answer hypothetical questions.
You're disgusting. But I like it. It's like going to a strip joint with a pope.
Fucking safari park.
It's cool. It's retro.
Exactly. What exactly is my plan here? Lured them all to the safari park like a Bond villain, but what's the aim?
Get to
torture myself with contact with an unattainable woman? Or what?
Yeah, I wasn't sure if I was going to make it because of my job, but my boss was actually really cool about it.
That's because it's not a real job.
Oh, yeah? What about this? Is that real enough for you?
Don't flaunt your wad, Jeremy. It's not becoming.
Well, you're becoming a pain in the arse. How do you like that?
You wanker, Corrigan.
Hey!
See how much money you earned this week.
Give it back, Jeremy.
Not a lot in here, Mark, apart from a couple of moths.
Give that back.
Oops. Butterfingers.
God damn.
For God's sake, Foz, stop the car. Stop the car, Foz. He's thrown my wallet out.
Oh, my God, he never.
Stop the car, Foz. It's Mark's wallet.
So, you're going to go and get it?
No, we need to call the warder.
Don't be a dick. Go and get it.
What if the lions eat me?
The lions aren't going to eat you, Mark. Just nip and get it.
You should go and get it.
I'm not going to get it.
Why should I have to bloody get it?
Oh, come on, Mark. Just get it. Get it.
Get it.
I'd whoop Jeremy's ass. Me and Jeremy would be fine.
I'm getting big laughs off humiliating my best mate. How can something so wrong feel so right?
Shit, this isn't good. There are lions. There are lions everywhere. Where are they? Is there one behind that tree? Jeremy's literally thrown me to the bloody lions.
That's
what
if they
next?
Let you get in the car.
Is he
going to
have me actually nailed onto a cross? Oh, you bloody bastard! Stop! Let me in! You bloody bastard!
Sonny, boss, for fuck's sake, stop!
All right. Oh, here comes.
Christ! What do you do to avoid lion attack? Soil yourself? Or is that grizzly bears? Hate to shit myself for no reason and get eaten. The final humiliation.
Like I said, I would have whooped Jeremy's ass.
Still nothing from Sophie.
Like big
probably
time.
Busy boning Jeff in Frankfurt. Highly unlikely, but possible. I should at least try to feel jealous and betrayed. Then I'll feel less of a shit about pursuing Sally.
Dude, you should call her first.
Hi, Jess. Nancy. You're here. I thought you'd be down at the Orgazoids.
Well, actually, Russell had to go off to Norway this morning, so I'm just here. Is that all right, Dad?
Well, yeah. Are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine.
What's bothering him? He's thinking about something.
Fuck.
He never normally thinks about things.
So will you ask him now?
Is it okay if Nancy uses the computer to redo her CV?
My computer?
Your computer, the computer, whatever.
Sally!
Sure. Hello?
Hi, Mark. How are you doing?
Oh, good. Good, thanks.
Listen, I'm so sorry about yesterday.
Oh, don't worry. That's fine. It was funny, probably. If it hadn't been happening to me, it might have been funny.
But look, it was great seeing you, and it would be great to meet up again.
Oh, right. Well, I'd love to.
How about tomorrow? I could drop round to your flat about 3?
Yeah, the flat. That sounds lovely. I can't invite her round here. Anyone could be here. Sophie will find out. Nothing's going to happen, but nothing must remain a total secret.
So, what's your address?
My address? Hold on, let me just check.
You need to check your address.
Well, I do like to be totally accurate. Jez, what's Russell's address?
Why?
Just give it to me.
No, why?
Because I'm a dirty dog, all right?
31 Bishops Avenue.
Hey, 31 Bishops Avenue.
This might backfire like a motherfucker.
So, see you tomorrow.
Yep, so see you
this
there.
This is going to backfire badly.
So
let's see how this goes.
Yes, do you think it would be all right if I sort of borrowed Russell's house?
No, I don't particularly want to go to that place right now, if I'm honest.
Well, that's okay. If you prefer, you can just give me the keys and I'll...
No, you need me to do the alarms. There's like 6 different alarms, but I'm just feeling a bit weird about the whole situation.
Yeah? Why?
Well, as it turns out, there were there are certain additional duties which I was expected to perform.
Duty. Okay, this what might duty? Be my, this might confirm my suspicions.
I'm his handyman.
Yes.
They give him handies.
It's just he did expect me to give him a hand.
So I was right. You gave him I was suspecting something was going on.
I helped him out.
Giving him a hand. Wow. Just to clarify, you do mean...
It was the speedo thing, and I was like, okay, wait a minute, hold up.
Shit. I knew it, okay. I knew it.
And now I don't know what to do. But on the one hand, it's a really good job. Puns. But on the other, I don't really want to go back to that place or have anything to do with him.
God, that's a really tough decision. Stay, so I can use the house.
I got Superhands to fill in yesterday. Said I was sick. There's loads needs doing before he comes back, but I just feel a bit dirty, you know?
Mm-hmm, yeah, I know what you mean. I feel the same sometimes.
Now you feel dirty.
From JLB and I've had to do loads of spreadsheets.
I don't think it is the same, Mark. I feel like my soul is being chipped away bit by bit.
Welcome to the world of work, Jeremy. You know, you don't have to be crazy to work here, but it
Fuck
helps.
Fuck your soul. You got almost got me eaten by lions, bitch. Geezers,
but that probably helps too.
Sit there
Why
and
don't you
suffer.
Tell me about the wanking off bit?
Sorry, I didn't think.
You should have bloody thought.
Jesus.
Did you do it?
Of course I did. How'd you feel about these trainers?
You don't think these trainers?
Hold on. Who's waking who up?
Jeremy's been wanking off this bloke for cash.
No, I haven't. It's not...
Jeremy, that is so you. I always knew you'd end up doing something like that.
What do you mean that is so me? That is not so me. So I have to jerk him off. But at least I get a lift home. Never mind. Only a few hand shandies between me and our home studio.
I had a chance to think in Norway. Us.
Us? Mm. Yeah?
I've never had to pay for it before, and I That's don't think funny. I want to pay for it with you.
Oh, right. So can I stop doing it?
So super hands left a hell of an impression.
I want you to keep doing it, but I want you to do it because you want to do it.
It's just... I don't really want to do it. Could I start wearing a mitten? Or maybe chuck a flannel over it?
It's just really difficult for me because I really like you. I just don't think we should see each other for a while. I'm going away to get my head together.
No, but the thing is, I really like you too. And I've been hiding my true feelings, even from myself. But now they're all coming out. What a lot of feelings.
I'm sorry, Jess.
Home studio slipping away. No, really, I mean it. I mean, I like you. I mean, fuck that. I love you, and I want to have sex with you.
No, Jeremy.
Come on, mate. Let me have a go on the old gear stick.
I am not a machine.
This is not what I want. Fuck off, Jez.
I am not a machine.
So, as it stands, I'm failing to find work as a prostitute. That doesn't feel good. Still, got his house keys. If I keep working for him, he'll have to keep paying me.
So this is your flat?
This is it. I call it a flat because I'm quite modest, but as you can see, it's actually quite a massive house.
Shit. Am I seriously hoping to have sex with Sally Slater? This is all very wrong.
I always knew you'd do well for yourself, Mark, but this is amazing.
Relax. You don't go to adulterous prison for drinking tea and playing Connect Four.
And Jeremy, is he like your butler?
Didn't they have something like this earlier in the world?
And I've been very lucky, and I like to spread that around.
Glad I sprayed my nuts with aftershave, though. You never know how things might turn out. I'm no Nostradamus.
I never knew anyone just
live
like this.
Somewhere that a rich person lives.
I just really appreciate the male form.
Right. No, I mean, I think it's kind of beautiful, I suppose.
Yeah, there is something beautiful about the male member. It's good to have a look at it now and again. A reminder of what can happen if you're
I might
care.
Have to censor that. I
what
know.
Am I saying?
I'm pretty sure I
At least
have to
he's going.
That, yeah.
Don't need a witness to this fiasco.
Here, Sally, I got you a present. Hitchhiker's Guide. It's the same copy we read from at Sutton Hoo. I got it signed by Douglas Adams when he came to the big W.H. Smith.
Oh, this is... It's lovely. Thank you. It's so romantic. It's the perfect way to start our affair.
Our affair. Okay, that sounds good.
Serious.
What sort of affair were you thinking of? The Dreyfus affair or more like the Watergate affair? Because I can tell you right now, I'm not burgling any Democrats.
Relax. We both want it to happen.
Oh, my God. She's going to kiss me. I'm such a bastard. I'm meant to be getting married.
Oh, she is.
I'm out of my depth. I thought she was a frightened little suburban mouse. But no, she's my nightmare. A liberated, sexually adventurous urban woman.
Sally, look, I'm really not sure I...
What am I doing? This isn't me. I can't have an affair. I'm not French. I'm the least French person on the planet.
Damn.
My favourite cheeses are cheddar and red Leicester.
A lot of French hate between these last couple
sorry,
of videos
Sally,
I've watched.
I just don't know if I can do this. I mean, you've got your miserable relationship, and the truth is I've got one of my own, and I just feel that, you know, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. And even if it is broke, just ignore it, and maybe it'll be sort of okay. Yeah. Like the environment. Who's the...
Is Russell back? Oh, no!
Foz!
Shit! He's fucking followed me again! He's obsessed with the idea that I'm screwing around on him.
Well, I suppose you are sort of trying to... Look, the door's locked.
Yes, don't finish the...
Great. Thanks, Jeremy.
Sally! Oh, shit! Hide! I'll just say I'm working here, cleaning.
I can't hide. I'm not a good hider. What the hell am I doing? I'm doing a Jeremy. This is a wake-up call.
Sally!
I've definitely hit a new low.
Foz, what are you doing here?
What the fuck are you doing here? You scream Winkerphone's mate!
Of course I'm bloody not. I'm cleaning, you asshole. This is Mark's flat and Jeremy's his servant.
Well, not servant, really. More of a...
Shit!
Now she calls.
What's that?
That's just the normal ringing noise. That's normal.
If she's cleaning Mark's house, why does Mark need to hide?
Must hide more. Can't hide more.
Corrigan. Are you spying on my wife? Are you winking at her?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, you gotta fall into the nickname.
I'm spying on her and wanking over her.
You really are a filthy little perv, aren't you?
Uh-huh, I suppose so.
I suppose so.
Come on, we're going.
Wow, he didn't hit me. Bit disappointing. I sort of deserve to be hit.
Cheer up, Mark. At least now you've got a funny story to tell people.
Yes.
That's kind of true.
No, I guess this is a pretty funny story.
One that I'll never ever tell anyone because of my deep and burning shame.
Oh, boy. the more I get down into this series, the more I learn that Jeremy is a piece of shit when it comes to being a friend. I'm sorry, but he is. Like I said, I would have whooped Jeremy's ass a long goddamn time ago. Like, we would have been fighting. He after the first season, it would have just been the Mark show because, yeah, I couldn't deal with that. He probably should have called Sophie a long time ago. That's what you should have done. The funny thing is, sometimes in those situations, and this is more of a serious discussion, it's not comedic or related to this technically, but a lot of times in those situations, each person is waiting for the other one to call first. And because you're waiting for the other one to call first, you don't call first. And thus, it ends up leading to both of you not talking to each other, which leads to both of you getting mad at each other. And you have this thing that didn't need to be so, like, serious, but now it is because of your egos. Just call them. You don't have to always, they don't have to always be the first one to call. Call and see what's going on. If they don't answer, then you have a reason to wait for them to call you. But, sometimes you just gotta be willing to make the sacrifice or be the bigger person and call first. I know I said be the bigger person like it's some type of fight or something, but in the beginning it's not. It's just call them. Let them know that you actually give a damn. And then maybe that will encourage them to call you in the future as well. But again, they call them once. If they don't call, let it go. Don't. keep trying to hit him up because that just becomes desperate and creepy. Well, maybe Mark should do that. I mean, he wants to break it off with Sophie. I don't know why he hasn't done the whole worse than you thought I was stick, where he just does the most horrible things possible. Like, after you start dating somebody for so long, you discover the real them. Because, let's be real, when you first meet somebody, you're meeting their representative. They're showing you what they want you to see. After a certain amount of time, they start to let those walls down, and then you see the real person. I don't know why Mark just doesn't pretend to be worse than what she would expect him to be. Like, walk around in your drawers with shit stains in them. Like, I'm just not like putting on fronts anymore. You know, putting his feet on the table, burping and farting on himself and shit, and cussing all the damn time. You know, something to make her not like him. Now, that could hurt your reputation if she went around and told everybody what type of person you were. That's a problem. But maybe you don't gotta go that extreme. Just do something that makes her want to break it off with you. But that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe, and share. I look forward to seeing you guys on future episodes. Next episode should be out on Thursday. I had to hesitate to make sure. Thursday, I think. But until then, I'm Devon DaVinci. Hopefully you've been enlightened. And I look forward to seeing you guys on a future episode. Deuces.